गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 2, एनिमल्स ऑन द ट्रैक. इट इज रिटन बाय रस्किन बॉन्ड. ओके, सो दिस इज क्वाइट इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर. लेट्स स्टार्ट टू रीड इट. ऑल अबोर्ड, श्रिक्ड पॉपाई, ग्रैंडमदर्स पेट पैरट. सो पॉपाई इज द पैरट विच इज द पेट ऑफ ग्रैंडमदर as we boarded the Lucknow Express. So all of them, as we see in this picture, grandfather, grandmother and their grandson, and the parrot which is Popeye. Here is a squirrel and here is a tiger. It's quite interesting a picture, isn't it? So they were boarding a train that is going to Lucknow Express. We are moving from Dehradun to Lucknow, so they are going to Lucknow from Dehradun. As you have noticed that I have given you some short type of question answers from chapter 1. We will discuss the other questions as well in our next classes, but first of all we have to sort out some short type of question answers from our text. Okay, so these things is quite important while we are reading the chapter. That is a short type of question answer, short type of informations rather. So please be careful. Grandmother had insisted on taking her parrot along. So it was grandmother's wish that they take the parrot with them. Grandfather and I also took our pets, grandfather's tiger and my small squirrel, with us. So the tiger was the pet of the grandfather, and the squirrel was a pet of that little child, but left the python behind. So they had a python too, which they left behind in their home. In those days the trains were not so crowded, so it turn the page so it was possible to travel with our pets. So the train was not so crowded as today's, and it was possible for them to carry their pets with them. In our fourth berth, first class compartment, Timothy the tiger had an entire berth. So what was the name of the tiger? Timothy. Okay, so they took the tiger with them, and the tiger occupied a berth in that train, entire berth to himself. Later everyone agreed that Timothy behaved perfectly throughout the journey. So it was a very nice view if we were there. Even the guard admitted that he could not have asked for a better passenger. No stealing from vendors, no shouting at coolies, no breaking of railway property, no spitting on the platform. So these things are quite usual thing that we may notice while we are boarding in a train, but as it is the part of the tiger, it did not do anything, any kind of thing like that. He was a perfect passenger. He was a good and civilized passenger, according to the guard. Before the train had moved out of Dehra station, Popeye had nipped two fingers and twisted and turned a ticket inspector's ear. So Popeye the parrot did a great kind of nuisance in there. So what did it do? It nipped two fingers and twisted and turned a ticket inspector's ears. So ticket inspector's ears, it twisted the ears of the ticket inspector. That is quite funny. Chips, my squirrel, came out from my pocket. So the name of the squirrel was Chips. Rushed out of the compartment door and scurried down the corridor. So it was moving vehemently. The travelers fed him roasted peanuts, and when he returned to our compartment, his tummy was almost bursting. So it gathered so many food from the travelers, the other travelers of the compartment. And when it returned to the little child, he found that it was quite the tummy of the squirrel was quite filled with the food. I think I will go to sleep, said grandfather. So who said this? Grandfather said this. covering herself, grandmother said this, covering herself with a blanket and stretching out on a berth. I am tired. Won't you eat something? Asked grandfather. So grandfather asked grandmother that you are going to sleep. You want to eat something or not? I am not hungry. You two help yourselves from the tiffin basket. So grandmother decided to go to sleep, and she advised us to take our tiffins from the basket. Grandmother dozed off, and even Popeye started nodding, lulled to sleep by the clackety clack of the wheels and the steady puffing of the steam engine. So it was when we travel by a train, the sound of the train makes us sleepy too. So that was with them also. I'm hungry, I said, I'm hungry. What did Granny make for us? Sandwiches, boiled eggs, a roast chicken, and gooseberries pie. It's all in the tiffin basket under your berth. So what were these things were there? These things were in their tiffin. I dragged the basket into the center of the compartment. I gasped with surprise when I opened the lid. So what did he found? In the basket was grandfather's python, pet python. So they thought that they had left the python in the home, but the fact was quite contrary to it, and the python was in the tiffin basket, curled up happily on the remains of our dinner. Remains, that means the python ate up all their dinners. Somehow it had managed to get into the tiffin basket. It slipped into the tiffin basket when they were busy in packing their luggage. And the python gets into the tiffin basket and ate up all the things they were going to have in their dinner. So, what are you staring at? Asked grandfather. Grandfather asked that, what are you staring at? It's the python, I said, and it has finished all of our dinner. So, the child reported the thing to the grandfather, that the python had ate up all the dinner. Grandfather and I looked down at what remained of the food. Pythons don't chew, they swallow. So it was their habit that they don't chew the food, they swallow the entire food. Outlined along the length of the large snake's smooth and shiny body were the shapes of the food it had eaten. So as they swallow the food, when the food get into the tummy of the python, it seems to us that from the outside of the skin that we may make out the shapes of the dinner from out of the skin. We couldn't make out the sandwiches, but they must have been eaten because there was no sign of them in the basket. So there were no sandwiches because the python had eaten up all the things. Only a few apples remained. So the python did not eat the apples. Grandfather shut the basket and pushed it back beneath the berth. So there was no use to open it anymore. We mustn't let grandmother see him. Grandmother see him, he said. Come to the next page. Well, I am hungry, I complained. Just then Chips returned from one of his forays and presented me with a peanut. So when the child complained that he was hungry, his pate, the chips, that is the quiddle, that is the squiddle, it came with a peanut and presented it to its master. Thanks, I said. If you keep bringing me peanuts all night, I might last until morning. So I will meet up my hunger if you bring me the peanuts, if you supply me the peanuts all through the night. The child told it to the squiddle. So we soon went to sleep. The only one who was wide awake was the squiddle, still investigating distant compartments. So it was investigating into the other compartments, that whether there is anything more left for him or not. A little after midnight, there was a great noise and activity at the end of the corridor. Grandfather and I woke up. So there was a noise in the corridor, and grandfather and the child woke up by the noise. Timothy growled. Timothy, that means the tiger. Timothy growled in his sleep, and Popeye made complaining noises. So they were habituated with their noises, but the human beings, they were not habituated with those kind of noises, especially the growling of the tiger. We heard cries of "Champ, Champ," the snake, that is the sound of the snake. Grandfather looked under the berth. The tiffin basket was empty, so it slipped out of the basket, and somehow it was managed to go for a stroll. The python out, he said, and we both dashed out of our compartment in search of those animals. "Anything wrong?" asked grandfather casually. "We can't get into the toilet," said someone. Someone told that we can't get into the toilet. So what happened? There is a huge snake inside. So the passenger was quite afraid that a snake was inside the toilet. So it's quite normal, because if we see that there is a python in the toilet, who dare to go into that toilet? "Let me see," said grandfather. "I know all about snakes." Grandfather entered the washroom to find the python curled up in the wash basin. So the python was curled up into the wash basin. After its heavy meal, it had become thirsty and had managed to open the lid of the basket and set out in search of water. So the python was out to search in water, to search of water. Grandfather gathered up the sleepy, overfed python. The python was very much sleepy, and it was overfed also. It had eaten up all the things, all the dinners, and that's why it was quite thirsty, and stepped out of the washroom. The passengers hastily made away for him. So the passengers were quite afraid of that. "Nothing to worry about," said grandfather cheerfully. "It's just a harmless young python. He's had his dinner already, so no one is in danger." So quite a dangerous talk it is, that he had done his dinner, so there is nothing, no worry for anyone. So every passenger will not be able to sleep anymore after hearing this kind of things. And he marched back to our compartment with the python in his arms. As soon as I was inside, he bolted the door. So he closed the door from inside. Grandmother was sitting up on her berth. So they were thinking, I thought, that what was in their mind that they thought to take those animals with them. So it was their fault or not, they were thinking about it. "I knew you would do something foolish behind my back," she scolded. "You told me you would got rid of that creature, and all the time you have been hiding it from me." So grandmother was not supporting all the things that had done by the grandfather. But grandfather is an animal lover, and he always took those animals with him. Grandfather explained that the python had got into the basket, but grandmother was most upset. "What will Mabel do when she sees it?" she cried. So perhaps they were going to someone's place, and Mabel is one of them to whom they were going. "My Aunt Mabel," here it is, "My Aunt Mabel, a school teacher in Lucknow." So they were going to Lucknow, all of them, and they were going to Aunt Mabel's house, and she was quite afraid of these kind of animals, so was terrified of all reptiles and especially snakes. "We won't let her see it," said grandfather. "So we will not allow her to see the python. Back it goes into the tiffin basket, and we will hide it into the tiffin basket." And Aunt Mabel, a lover of good food, met us at the station and immediately spotted the tiffin basket and picked it up. "It's not very heavy," she said. "I hope." So, they were quite afraid of the fact that Aunt Mabel might find it, and Aunt Mabel took the tiffin basket in which the python was there. "You have kept some food for me." "It's all yours, Auntie," I said. "So all the food which we have brought, that is for you." "Oh, good," exclaimed Aunt Mabel. "It's been ages since I tasted something cooked by your grandmother. So it's quite a long time that I didn't taste it. I haven't tasted anything that is cooked by your grandmother." So she was quite excited about the food that she was going to eat. And she was going to find what she was going to find in the tiffin basket and what is awaiting for her. So let's see. The whole family got into an enormous taxi. Because why is the taxi so enormous? Because Timothy was on the back seat. Aunt Mabel sat on the front seat with grandmother, the tiffin basket on her lap. So the tiffin basket was on the lap of Aunt Mabel, who was so much scared about the snakes. So see what is going to happen. "I am dying to see what's inside." So she was quite excited to know that what kind of food was waiting for her in that basket. She said, "Can't I take just a little peek?" So she wants to have a peek or have a peep into the basket. "Not now," said grandfather. Grandfather was quite worried about that if it happens that she get a chance to peep into the basket, she will be out of her sense. "But first, let's enjoy the breakfast you have got waiting for us. So first of all, we just want to have the breakfast that you have made for us." "Yes, wait until we get home," said grandmother. "Now tell the taxi driver where to take us, dear. He's looking rather nervous." Why the taxi driver was nervous? You know that. You can guess that. Because there were so many animals with them. And after all, there was a tiger with them. And why the taxi driver will not be so nervous? Aunt Mabel gave instructions to the driver and the taxi shot off in a cloud of dust. Well, here we go. So after the description was given, or the direction was given to the taxi driver, they started off. Said grandfather, "I'm looking forward to settling into the new house." So they were talking about their new house. Popeye perched on grandmother's shoulder. So Popeye was on the shoulder of grandmother, keeping one suspicious eye on the quivering tiffin basket. So Popeye was keeping a suspicious eye on the basket, tiffin basket, and it is going to unveil all the truth in front of Aunt Mabel. Maybe. Let's see. "When we got into our new house, a light breakfast was waiting for us." "It isn't much," said Aunt Mabel, "but we'll supplement it with the food in your tiffin box." So she was quite interested in what was in the tiffin box. With this, she opened the basket. The python was half asleep with an apple in its mouth. So the python was going to eat up or swallow the apple which was in its mouth. Aunt Mabel fainted, as I have told you. She got fainted with the view of that python. Grandfather picked up the python and hung it on the guava tree. So grandfather took no more risk about the python, and he took it and hung it on the guava tree in the garden. Aunt Mabel soon felt better and insisted that there was a huge snake in the tiffin basket. So she was quite afraid. But she didn't know that the snake is in the garden, in her. We showed her the empty basket. So, you see, there is no snake in the basket, Aunt. So, there is nothing to be worried about. They all tell Auntie, "You are seeing things," said Grandfather. "So, that is an illusion. That is an illusion you have seen in the basket. There is no snake in the basket," he told that. It must be the heat. You are heat stricken and you see an illusion. Okay. So with that thing they concluded and the story came to an end for us. So it is your turn now to read the story yourself and read this word notes while you read the story. Okay. And in our next class, we will discuss about the question answers. Okay. Thank you.